We're going on with our next guest. Please join us in the studio, Aad van den Berg. Good morning.
Thank you. Good morning.
You're director of DLV Green Q.
Correct.
What is it that you do?
DLV Green Q is a knowledge company. We provide, we develop and we provide knowledge about horticulture worldwide.
And you're also very into digital growing.
Yes.
Please explain more about that.
At this moment we have an experimental in digital growing. That means that the grower, the manager of the greenhouse, did not enter the greenhouse at all during 6 weeks until now. So he's managing behind the computer.
So you don't have to be in the greenhouse at all?
The manager does not need to be in the greenhouse anymore. We have sensor technology, vision technology, and manual measurements from the plant. That all together is enough data for him to manage the crop on distance. So brains before muscles.
And what are the biggest challenges in that?
Biggest challenge is that a grower normally feels the environment of the plant and he sees the plant. And to make that feeling of environment and the picture of the plant virtual and to analyze that in the right way, that's the biggest challenge. So from human feelings to virtual data and management information. That's the biggest challenge.
Yeah, a very big development, the digital growing.
Yes, yes, yes.
And you're here today on the summit. You're also sponsoring our show from Green Q. We're really thankful for that.
You're welcome.
Thank you for that. And
you're welcome.
Why do you think it's so important, this summit and this show as well?
Well, first of all, I was really triggered by the live stream. Because if you speak about digital growing, you use internet for all kinds of applications, and live stream is also internet. So that internet is bridging our know-how and this show worldwide to everyone in the world.
Yeah, we're connected to a lot of countries right now.
Connected to a lot of countries, and that's really the picture for the future. What was your question?
That was it. That was the question.
That was it. Okay.
And my next question is going to be, how important is this summit and also the event next year for the International Horticulture Society?
In the Netherlands, we are leading in horticulture. But in 2050, there will be 9 billion inhabitants of the world. They need to be fed. So food production needs to be explored worldwide, and mainly about around the big metropoles in the world. And that means there are new ways of farming, not on the square meter, but farming will be in the cubic meter. Vertical farming, urban farming, and these kind of things. And our know-how from the Netherlands, we are leading in horticulture, that should be spread out in the world. And GreenTech and the summit is one of the platforms to do so.
Yeah, and technology is rising also in horticulture. Can you say muscle over brain or brain over muscle?
Brain over muscle.
Brain over
yes.
muscle.
And the nice thing is, horticulture, agriculture is mainly a man business. And if it comes to brains, ladies are welcome also.
So that's going to be a change maybe in the future, more ladies in the horticulture.
Men should get used to that, for sure.
And what would be the value to added value to that, you think? Of course, I know, but
yeah,
I just want to hear you say.
Well, I have a couple of daughters at home, so I know a little bit about it also.
Yes.
But men are very rational.
Yeah.
Thinking and working by the hands. Women are more sensitive, feeling. And if it comes to food production, it comes to flavor, taste, shape, quality, etc. And I'm sure ladies are more capable to get into those developments, more
so
than men.
The business is changing a lot.
Business is changing. And I see that worldwide. I visit China often, and many, many ladies are there involved already. So, well, the future is for horticulture, but the future is for ladies also.
And what is the main thing that should be improved this year, you say?
This year? Improved? In horticulture, you mean
yes,
in general?
Yes, in horticulture, yes.
Well, I learned this morning from Richard van Hooydonk, we have to find the white beers in our company first. We have to avoid
Please
the black beers.
Please define that.
Sorry?
Please define that. Can you explain it?
The white beer the black bear is the one who doesn't not want to change.
No.
The white bear is the one who wants to change, who has eye for the picture for the future. And we need those kind of people in our companies.
The flexible
people getting new challenges. I'm 50 years already, sorry.
I'm still very young.
Thank you. but I'm already limited in my thinking about using new technologies like internet and all these kind of things. So we need young people to make those changes in our company and in the market.
Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
And thank you also for sponsoring us on this live show.
It was a great pleasure. Thank you very much.
Have a good day.
Thank you.